is Jyotsna Ramachandran, and in this episode, I'm going to tell you what's that one thing you need to do to become an author this year. Hey there, if you're a person who has been writing in your goal list every year, year after year, that you need to write a book and it's just not happening, then this episode is for you. Because I see so many people who are really so talented at what they do and they really have that wish to become an author, but it just does not materialize, it just does not become a reality. And I noticed that there is just this one thing that you need to do to become an author this year, and that is to make your book your one thing. Yes, I heard this concept for the first time in this book called The One Thing, and it's a fantastic read. Please do read it when you get time. And in this book, the author shares a lot of wonderful concepts to be more productive. And I'm going to be sharing some ideas that I learned from this book, which I have personally used and seen so many successful authors use. So if you really want to bring out your book this year, you need to make it your one thing. So what do I mean by that? See, as people who are ambitious and who want to be really successful, we want to do so many things in all the different areas of our life. And if you are a big believer in goal setting like me, I'm sure you have a big list of goals that you want to achieve this year. But here's the important thing. Not every goal is equally important. We need to realize that. And from the big list of goals that we have, it is wise to choose only three goals as your big three for every year. So not more than one goal per quarter. So if writing your book is your priority, then pick writing your book as one of the main goals for the year and give it an entire quarter of the year to just focus on your writing. Unless you give it that level of importance, it's never going to happen, because big projects require big focus, and writing your book is one such project for sure. Now let's assume that you've decided that in quarter one or quarter two, your one thing is going to be your book. But let's look at reality. What happens is that you may want to focus on the book, but there are so many distractions out there, so many new opportunities out there that will knock at your door, and you will feel so bad to turn them down. So here is the thing that you need to look out for. Whenever something comes to you in the form of an opportunity, it may be great for your life, but ask yourself, should I do it right now? If it's not important right now, please be okay to intentionally procrastinate it. Please defer it. It's not necessary that you need to do it now. Because if you try to do multiple things at the same time, you cannot be really like a master juggler. Multitasking is a myth and it's not going to work, especially for an important project that needs your time and focus, like writing your book. So when you see the next webinar on how to create your online course, how to start your podcast, how to find a business partner or whatever, there could be so many interesting things happening around you, which could be great for your life and business, but it need not happen right now. You can do that after 3 months, right? So be intentional in saying no to these things and don't feel bad about it. You need to make that decision to focus on the book, and you need to also make the decision to defer some other projects that are not important right now, and you need not feel bad about it. Because if you see, most high achievers are really focused on one thing at a time. And that's the only way to succeed without having to feel guilty about not making use of other opportunities around you. Now finally, when you have chosen that your book is your one thing and you've removed all those distractions and opportunities out of your way, you will have to look at your productivity level on a daily basis. Which means, how is your time getting used up on a given day? Are you using it towards your book, or is it taking you to other directions? So here's the thing, your one thing is not just for your quarter, but you should also have one thing for your day. See, your 24 hours will have a lot of different activities for different areas of your life, which is great. But your one thing for your day should be in alignment with your one thing for the quarter. So say your one thing for the quarter is to lose 5 kgs or whatever, your one thing for the day has to be in tandem with that, and it cannot be something else. So if you've decided that this quarter is going to be for your book, then your one thing for every single day in the next 3 to 4 months should also be related to the book. Now you may wonder, what about all the other essential things that are so important, like your family, your health, your friends, your spiritual life? Now, what is recommended by the author of The One Thing, which I totally agree, is this. Look at all the things you need to do in life and classify it into two buckets. One is your professional bucket, which has all your business and career and work-related tasks. And the other is everything else. It could be your hobbies, your passion, your family, your health, and all of that. Now, the other bucket is something that's really, really precious. You cannot lose your health. You cannot lose your relationships just because you're focusing on your one thing, right? So those activities need a minimum maintenance. You need to go on a weekly date with your spouse. You need to take care of your kids. You need to work out for an hour a day. You cannot skip all of that just because you're focused on your one thing. So ensure that the minimum maintenance is happening for all your other things in life. And when it comes to your work-related tasks, if you choose your book to be your one thing at this point of time, then you need to give your undivided attention and focus towards the book task for longer hours during the day. That's the only way you can balance your big one thing related to your work and all the other things in your life. The final tip that I want to leave you with is scheduling large chunks of time in your calendar for your one thing. Now, you may decide to dedicate a lot of hours for the book project, but if you end up scheduling just 30-minute blocks here and there, then you're not giving it the focus that it deserves. But what really works is if you give it a longer stretch of time, which could be at least a couple of hours together. Ideally, if you can just give 4 hours a day, even if it's just twice a week, that is more than enough to help you to finish your book in 3 to 4 months. So this is how you distinguish between deep work and shallow work. Shallow work is everything that really does not require your focus. Of course, you need to be doing those tasks like checking your email, answering calls, and all of that. That may be important for your business, but it really does not require your attention and focus. So those kind of tasks can take anywhere between 10 minutes to 30 minutes, which is fine. So those are the shallow tasks. But deep work, like writing a book, doing anything else that is really creative, takes longer hours. So you cannot break it down into smaller chunks. Ideally, if you're able to give a larger block of time and actually time block it in your calendar, it will happen. I have seen authors who just book themselves in a resort, even if it's in their own city, they just go on a staycation and over an entire weekend. But if they were to do this from home, they will have so many distractions and it'll never happen. So time blocking for a longer duration of time, looking at your book project as your one thing and doing that deep work would really help you to accomplish that book project this year. I hope you found all these tips useful. Do let me know if you've tried any of them, if it worked, if it didn't. Please let me know all of that in the comments. I will read every single comment and also reply. So make sure you share what worked for you so that we can all together benefit. If your book is your one thing for this year and you need some support in making it a reality, then you can speak to my team at Happy Self Publishing. Just head over to happyselfpublishing.com/apply. Having this commitment towards your book project is just one of the 5 attributes that a successful author needs to have. I have another episode where I talk about the remaining 4 attributes which you should not miss. So do go check it out. You can either see it in my YouTube channel or check out the podcast. And before you leave, make sure you like and subscribe. That really, really matters, okay? I really appreciate that. Until next episode, happy authoring!